Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and in this video, I'm sharing the best Google Calendar features. Gcal is full of great features, and there are so many of them that many useful ones could go unused or unnoticed. Now, last year I posted a video on Google Calendar tips and tricks, which I'll link to up here again at the end of the video and again in the description below this video. So I won't really go over any of those in this video right here, but I will highlight some of the best Google Calendar features for 2020. So first up is to customize your calendar view to tailor to your needs. To start, you can create a custom calendar view and utilize shortcuts to toggle between views. So in your Gcal, just above your calendar view, you'll have a drop-down menu to the right of your settings gear. Click that menu and you can adjust your calendar view to be day, week, month, year, a specific schedule, 4 days, and you can toggle to show weekends and declined events. Notice the letters to the right of your options here. These are shortcuts. So from your main Gcal page, if you hit one of these letters, you'll be adjusted to that view automatically. So for example, I'll hit X and bam, my view shows 4 days now. And I'll hit W to take me back to the week view. So that's grand, but as promised, you can customize your view even further. Hit that gear icon in the top right and head to your settings. Then on the left-hand side of your settings, select View Options. Now you have even more options to further customize your view. You can also change the display density and color settings of your calendar. This is useful if you want to be able to see more of your calendar events on your screen. So back in your Gcal, click that gear icon again and select Density and Color. In this pop-up, you can change the default color and the density to be more compact. All right, in the last video I did, I talked about how you can easily create, add, and share a calendar. So if you have multiple calendars set up like I do, easily toggle between them to show only one at a time. You'll have all of your calendars to the left of your Cal view. Here you can see which ones are enabled. Rather than click them manually on or off, just hover over the calendar you want to view, and then click the vertical three-dot menu icon and select Display This Only. Instantly, that's the only calendar viewable. The next tip is to take advantage of the time zone features in Gcal. For example, did you know you can set up a world clock right in your Gcal and you can schedule meetings across multiple time zones? Well, yes to both, and here's how. From your Gcal, click your settings gear icon and head back to settings. Select world clock on the left-hand side and then toggle on the show world clock option. Now right underneath that, select add time zone for any locations you want to monitor. You can add them all here. Through the magic of time lapse, I'll add all my locations in the world where I have family. Now back in the calendar view, blammo, you have all the time zones you enabled right there on the left-hand side of your calendar. Finally, no more Googling, what time is it in Italy? Game changer. So now it's time to manage appointments across time zones. Okay, we're back in the settings section and select time zone from the left. Toggle on the option to display a secondary time zone. Just select the second time zone you want to display, and then you can even label it here too. So back in your calendar, you'll notice both time zones, so you instantly know what time zone your client is on when you're scheduling your next meeting. So I mentioned a few keyboard shortcuts for toggling between your calendar view, but there's a few more you're going to want to take note of. First, from anywhere in Google Calendar, hit the Escape key to jump back to your main calendar view. Second, rather than hit arrows continuously to find a date on your calendar, just press G and type in the date you want from the pop-up and then hit go and voila, you are transported to that date. Third, once you've scrolled through your calendar, press T to quickly return to today's date. To learn even more cool keyboard shortcuts, I highly encourage you to watch the video I did before, which again is linked below. And I'll also add a link to a full list of Gcal shortcuts there as well. Okay, so next up, did you know you could recover a deleted Gcal event? You actually have 30 days to do so. Yes, that's right, Google Calendar has a trash bin of its own. So click that gear icon and select trash. Then pick the event you need to recover and select Restore All Selected. Next up, transfer ownership of an event. This is really useful if you set up an event you can no longer make it to, but the event still needs to go on. Simply click on the event in your Gcal and then select the menu option, those three vertical dots, and select Change Owner. All you have to do here is type in the person you want to change ownership to and press OK. If you like these tips, be sure to watch my other video by clicking right here. Do it anytime. And now I want to hear from you guys. What are your favorite Google Calendar features and why? Let everybody know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I want to know, so give it a like, a share, or leave a comment below. Remember to watch that other video or click right about here to subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.